This audiobook, Life is a Game, Play Smart, Win Big, is your strategic edge. In this groundbreaking guide, you'll learn to 1. Master game theory for real-life success. 2. Develop unbeatable personal and professional strategies. 3. Anticipate challenges before they arise. 4. Create foolproof plans for achieving your goals. 5. Navigate life's complexities with newfound confidence. Whether you're climbing the corporate ladder, launching a business, or seeking personal growth, this book provides the tools to outsmart obstacles, seize opportunities, and emerge victorious in the game of life. Get ready to unlock your strategic genius and win big in every arena. Chapter 1: Introduction to the Game of Life. Imagine life as a grand chessboard where every move you make shapes your future. Welcome to the game of life, where strategy isn't just a concept, it's the key to unlocking your full potential and achieving remarkable success. In this fascinating game, the rules are complex, the players diverse, and the stakes higher than any conventional game you've ever played. But unlike traditional games, in life, you have the power to influence the rules, change the players, and even redefine what winning means to you. This is where the powerful lens of game theory comes into play, offering a unique perspective on how to navigate the intricate web of decisions and interactions that make up our daily lives. Game theory, a field pioneered by brilliant minds like John von Neumann and John Nash, provides a framework for understanding strategic decision-making in competitive situations. Originally developed to analyze economic behavior, its principles have since been applied to fields as diverse as biology, politics, and psychology. Now, we're bringing these powerful concepts directly to you to help you master the game of life. But why is strategic thinking so crucial? In a world of increasing complexity and rapid change, those who can think several moves ahead, anticipate others' actions, and adapt their strategies accordingly have a distinct advantage. Whether you're negotiating a business deal, planning your career, or simply trying to improve your relationships, the ability to think strategically can be the difference between merely participating in life and truly excelling. The beauty of applying game theory to your life lies in its practical benefits. It helps you make better decisions by considering not just your immediate gains, but also the long-term consequences of your choices. It teaches you to understand and predict the behavior of others, allowing you to navigate social and professional situations with greater ease. Perhaps most importantly, it empowers you to create win-win scenarios where your success doesn't come at the expense of others, but rather contributes to a greater overall good. As we embark on this journey together, we'll explore the fundamental concepts of game theory and how they apply to real-world situations. We'll delve into strategies for mapping out your life's playing field, setting winning goals, and crafting a game plan that aligns with your values and strengths. You'll learn how to make decisions under uncertainty, negotiate effectively, and build strategic relationships that propel you towards success. This book is designed to be your personal playbook for life. Each chapter builds upon the last, providing you with a comprehensive toolkit for strategic living. Whether you're a student just starting out, a professional looking to advance your career, or someone simply seeking to make better decisions in your personal life, you'll find valuable insights and actionable strategies within these pages. As we close this introduction and prepare to dive deeper into the world of strategic thinking, remember that the game of life is already in progress. Every day, you're making moves on this grand chessboard. The question is, are you playing reactively, or are you strategically shaping the game to your advantage? In the next chapter, we'll begin to equip you with the fundamental tools of game theory, setting the stage for a transformation in how you approach life's challenges and opportunities. The game is afoot, and your journey to mastering it is just beginning. Before we go on, make sure to subscribe to Grow to the Top and hit the notification bell to receive more strategic knowledge that will supercharge your growth and your future. Chapter 2: Fundamentals of Game Theory. In the vast arena of life, understanding the rules of the game is the first step towards mastery. Game theory provides us with a powerful set of tools to decode these rules, offering insights that can revolutionize our approach to decision-making and strategic planning. At its core, game theory is the study of strategic decision-making in situations where the outcome depends not just on your own choices, but also on the choices of others. It's a framework that helps us understand and predict behavior in competitive and cooperative scenarios, ranging from simple two-person interactions to complex multiplayer situations. Let's start by exploring some key concepts and terminology. In game theory, a game refers to any situation where there are multiple decision makers, players, whose choices affect each other's outcomes. These games can be classified in various ways. Cooperative games involve players working together towards a common goal, while non-cooperative games involve players acting in their own self-interest. Zero-sum games are situations where one player's gain is exactly balanced by another's loss, while non-zero-sum games allow for outcomes where all players can benefit or lose simultaneously. One of the most famous examples in game theory is the prisoner's dilemma, a scenario that illustrates the tension between individual and collective rationality. In this hypothetical situation, two criminals are arrested and interrogated separately. Each has the option to either betray the other or remain silent. The outcomes depend on the choices both make, with the best collective outcome achieved if both remain silent, but the temptation to betray for individual gain always present. This scenario introduces us to the concept of Nash equilibrium, named after mathematician John Nash. A Nash equilibrium is a situation where no player can unilaterally improve their outcome by changing only their own strategy. In the prisoner's dilemma, the Nash equilibrium is often for both prisoners to betray, even though this leads to a worse outcome for both compared to if they had cooperated. Understanding these concepts isn't just an academic exercise. It has profound implications for real-life decision-making. Consider how often we face situations where our outcomes depend on both our choices and those of others. From business negotiations to personal relationships, the principles of game theory can guide us towards more strategic and beneficial decisions. Another crucial aspect of game theory is the role of information in decision-making. In many real-world scenarios, we don't have perfect information about all factors influencing our decisions. This concept of information asymmetry, where different players have access to different information, is a key consideration in strategic thinking. For example, in a job negotiation, the employer typically has more information about the company's financial situation and the true value of the position, while the candidate has more information about their own skills and alternative opportunities. Recognizing and navigating these information imbalances can be crucial to achieving favorable outcomes. The power of game theory lies in its ability to provide a structured way of thinking about complex interactions. By breaking down situations into their component parts, players, strategies, payoffs, and information, we can gain insights that might not be apparent at first glance. This analytical approach allows us to anticipate potential outcomes, identify optimal strategies, and make more informed decisions. As we conclude this introduction to the fundamentals of game theory, it's important to recognize that these concepts are just the beginning. They provide a foundation upon which we can build more sophisticated strategies for navigating life's complexities. In the chapters to come, we'll explore how to apply these principles to develop a truly strategic mindset, one that not only understands the game, but excels at playing it. The stage is set, and the pieces are in place. But to truly master the game of life, we need more than just knowledge of the rules. We need to cultivate a mindset that allows us to see beyond the immediate moves and envision the entire board. In our next chapter, we'll delve into the characteristics of strategic thinkers and explore how you can develop this crucial skill set, setting the stage for your transformation into a master player in the game of life. Chapter 3, Developing a Strategic Mindset. In the grand game of life, having the right mindset is as crucial as knowing the rules. A strategic mindset is the lens through which master players view the world, enabling them to see opportunities where others see obstacles, to plan several moves ahead, and to adapt swiftly when the game changes unexpectedly. At its core, a strategic mindset is characterized by a unique set of cognitive skills and attitudes. Strategic thinkers possess keen analytical abilities, allowing them to break down complex situations into manageable components. They excel at pattern recognition, quickly identifying trends and connections that others might miss. Perhaps most importantly, they are adept problem solvers, capable of generating creative solutions to challenges that seem insurmountable to others. Developing these skills requires practice and dedication. It involves training your mind to consistently ask probing questions. What are the long-term consequences of this decision? How might other players respond to my actions? What unseen factors could influence the outcome? By habitually engaging in this type of critical thinking, you begin to see the world in terms of interconnected systems rather than isolated events. However, even the most analytically gifted individuals can fall prey to cognitive biases, systematic errors in thinking that can lead to poor judgments and decision-making. These biases are hardwired into our brains, evolved shortcuts that once helped our ancestors survive, but can now lead us astray in our complex modern world. Common biases include confirmation bias, where we tend to seek out information that confirms our pre-existing beliefs, and the sunk cost fallacy, where we continue investing in a losing proposition simply because we've already invested so much. Overcoming these biases is a crucial step in developing a truly strategic mindset. The first step in overcoming cognitive biases is simply being aware of their existence. By understanding the ways in which our minds can trick us, we can be more vigilant in our decision-making processes. Techniques such as seeking out diverse perspectives, actively challenging our own assumptions, and using structured decision-making frameworks can help mitigate the impact of these biases. Another key aspect of the strategic mindset is the ability to maintain a long-term perspective. In a world that often demands immediate results, the ability to delay gratification and work towards distant goals is a powerful differentiator. This doesn't mean ignoring short-term needs or opportunities, but rather finding a balance between immediate concerns and long-term aspirations. Cultivating this long-term perspective involves developing the ability to envision multiple possible futures and plan accordingly. It requires patience and persistence, as well as the wisdom to know when to stay the course and when to pivot in response to changing circumstances. Flexibility and adaptability are crucial components of this long-term thinking. The most successful strategists understand that no plan survives contact with reality unchanged. They build flexibility into their strategies, continuously reassess their position, and are willing to adjust their approach when necessary. Developing a strategic mindset also involves honing your emotional intelligence. Understanding and managing your own emotions, as well as being able to read and influence the emotions of others, is crucial in navigating the complex social dynamics that underpin many of life's most important games. As you work on cultivating these qualities, remember that developing a strategic mindset is not about becoming cold or calculating. Rather, it's about expanding your perspective, enhancing your decision-making abilities, and ultimately, increasing your capacity to achieve your goals and create positive outcomes for yourself and others. The journey to developing a strategic mindset is ongoing. It requires constant learning, self-reflection, and a willingness to step out of your comfort zone. But with each step, you'll find yourself better equipped to navigate life's challenges and seize its opportunities. As we conclude this exploration of the strategic mindset, we stand at the threshold of putting these principles into action. You've learned about the game, you understand its fundamental concepts, and you're developing the mindset of a master player. But every game takes place on a specific field with its own unique features and challenges. In the next chapter, we'll begin the crucial process of mapping out your personal playing field, identifying the key players, understanding the rules that govern your specific game, and recognizing the unique opportunities and challenges that lie before you. The board is set, and it's time for you to make your move. Chapter 4, Identifying Your Playing Field. Every game has its arena, And in the game of life, your playing field is as unique as you are. It's a complex tapestry woven from your personal circumstances, professional environment, social networks, and the broader societal context in which you operate. Understanding this playing field is crucial to developing effective strategies and making informed decisions. Imagine yourself as a general surveying a battlefield. Your first task is to map out the terrain, identifying key features, potential obstacles, and strategic vantage points. In life, this process involves taking a comprehensive look at the various arenas in which you operate, your career, relationships, personal development, and any other areas that are significant to you. Start by examining your professional arena. What industry are you in? What are its current trends and future projections? Who are the key players, your colleagues, superiors, competitors? What are the rules, both explicit and implicit, that govern success in this field? Understanding these elements allows you to position yourself strategically, anticipating changes and seizing opportunities before others even notice them. Next, consider your personal arena. This includes your relationships, health, personal growth, and any passion projects or hobbies. Each of these areas has its own set of stakeholders, rules, and potential for growth or conflict. By mapping out these personal territories, you can ensure that your life strategies are holistic, taking into account all aspects of your well-being and satisfaction. As you survey your playing field, pay close attention to the other players. In game theory, understanding the motivations and potential actions of other players is crucial to formulating winning strategies. In your life, these players include not just direct competitors, but also allies, mentors, family members, and even seemingly neutral parties whose actions could impact your outcomes. Analyze these players carefully. What are their goals? What resources do they have at their disposal? How might their actions affect your own plans? Remember, in the game of life, players can shift roles. Today's competitor might be tomorrow's ally, and vice versa. By understanding the dynamics between different players, you can navigate these relationships more effectively, building alliances where beneficial and mitigating potential conflicts. An often overlooked but crucial aspect of your playing field is the set of rules that govern it. Some rules are explicit, laws, regulations, company policies. Others are implicit, social norms, unspoken expectations, cultural values. Identifying these rules is essential because they define the boundaries within which you must operate and the criteria by which success is judged. However, don't fall into the trap of seeing these rules as immutable. Part of playing the game of life at an advanced level is recognizing which rules can be bent, which can be reinterpreted, and which might even be changed altogether. Innovators and game changers throughout history have often been those who saw beyond the apparent limitations of their playing field and found ways to reshape it to their advantage. As you map out your playing field, also be aware of the constraints you face. These might be limitations in resources, time, or opportunities. But remember, constraints can often be turned into advantages. Limited resources can foster creativity and efficiency. Time constraints can drive focus and productivity. By understanding your constraints, you can develop strategies that not only work within them, but leverage them for success. The process of identifying your playing field is not a one-time event. The game of life is dynamic, with the terrain constantly shifting. New players enter the game, rules change, and what once was a barren field might become fertile ground for opportunity. Regular reassessment of your playing field is crucial to maintaining a winning strategy. As we conclude this exploration of your life's playing field, you should have a clearer picture of the game you're playing. You've surveyed the terrain, identified the players, and understood the rules and constraints that shape your particular game. But a map, no matter how detailed, is just the beginning. To truly excel, you need to know where you're going. In the next chapter, we'll delve into the art of setting winning goals, the beacons that will guide your journey across this complex playing field you've mapped out. The landscape is clear. Now it's time to chart your course to victory. Chapter 5, Setting Winning Goals. In the grand game of life, having a clear destination is as crucial as understanding the terrain. Setting winning goals is the process of defining what success looks like for you, providing direction and purpose to your strategic efforts. It's about painting a vivid picture of your desired future and creating a roadmap to get there. The art of goal setting begins with clarity. Vague aspirations like being successful or finding happiness are too nebulous to guide effective action. Winning goals are specific and well-defined. They answer precise questions. What exactly do you want to achieve? By when? How will you know when you've achieved it? As you define your goals, it's essential to strike a balance between short-term and long-term objectives. Short-term goals provide immediate focus and quick wins, fueling your motivation and building momentum. Long-term goals, on the other hand, give you a broader perspective, ensuring that your day-to-day efforts are aligned with your larger life aspirations. However, not all goals are created equal. To truly drive your success, your objectives need to be smart, specific, measurable, achievable, relevant, and time-bound. This framework transforms vague wishes into concrete targets, providing a clear standard against which to measure your progress. Specific goals leave no room for ambiguity. Instead of improve my career, a specific goal might be secure a promotion to senior manager in my department. Measurable goals include concrete criteria for tracking progress. Increase my savings becomes save 20% of my monthly income. Achievable goals stretch your abilities without setting you up for failure. While ambition is admirable, goals that are too far out of reach can be demotivating. Relevant goals align with your values and larger life objectives. They answer the question, does this matter to me? Time-bound goals include a deadline, creating a sense of urgency and helping you prioritize your efforts. Learn a new language becomes achieve B2 proficiency in Spanish within 18 months. As you set your SMART goals, it's crucial to ensure they align with your values and play to your strengths. Goals that resonate with your core beliefs and natural talents are more likely to inspire sustained effort and lead to fulfillment. This alignment turns goal pursuit from a chore into a deeply satisfying journey. Visualization is a powerful tool in goal setting. Take the time to imagine, in vivid detail, what achieving your goals will look and feel like. This mental imagery not only increases your motivation, but also helps your brain recognize opportunities that align with your objectives. Once you've defined your SMART goals and aligned them with your values, the next step is to break them down into actionable steps. This process transforms distant dreams into concrete plans. Start with your end goal and work backwards, identifying the major milestones you'll need to reach along the way. For each milestone, define the specific actions required to achieve it. This creates a series of manageable tasks, making even the most ambitious goals feel attainable. It also provides a clear roadmap for your day-to-day decisions, ensuring that your actions consistently move you towards your objectives. As you pursue your goals, it's important to build in regular check-ins and assessments. The path to success is rarely a straight line, and flexibility is key. These periodic reviews allow you to measure your progress, celebrate your wins, and adjust your approach as needed. Remember, goal setting is not a one-time event, but an ongoing process. As you grow and evolve, and as circumstances change, your goals may need to shift as well. What seemed important a year ago might be less relevant now, or you might discover new aspirations as you progress. Be prepared to adjust your goals over time, ensuring they always reflect your current values and ambitions. Setting winning goals is about more than just defining targets. It's about creating a compelling vision of your future that inspires and guides you. It's about translating your deepest aspirations into concrete plans of action. With clear, motivating goals in place, you have a powerful tool for navigating the complex game of life. As we conclude this exploration of goal setting, you should have a clearer picture of what you're striving for in the game of life. You've defined your objectives, aligned them with your values, and broken them down into actionable steps. But even the most well-defined goals are just the beginning. To bring them to fruition, you need a solid game plan. In our next chapter, we'll delve into the art of strategy development. exploring how to craft a plan that will turn your goals into reality. Your destination is set. Now it's time to chart the course that will take you there. Chapter 6, Crafting Your Game Plan. With a clear understanding of your playing field and well-defined goals, you're now ready to craft your game plan, the strategic roadmap that will guide your actions and decisions as you navigate the complex game of life. This is where the rubber meets the road, where lofty aspirations are transformed into concrete strategies and tactics. Crafting an effective game plan begins with developing actionable strategies. These are the broad approaches you'll take to achieve your goals, the overarching methods that will shape your decisions and actions. Think of strategies as the major moves in your game, the key initiatives that will position you for success. For each of your major goals, brainstorm potential strategies. What are the different paths you could take to reach your objective? Which approaches play to your strengths? Which minimize your vulnerabilities? Consider both conventional and innovative strategies, drawing on your understanding of the game and your unique position within it. As you develop your strategies, it's crucial to think in both long-term and short-term dimensions. Long-term strategies provide the big-picture direction, ensuring that your actions are aligned with your ultimate objectives. Short-term tactics, on the other hand, are the specific moves you'll make in the immediate future to implement your strategies and make progress towards your goals. Prioritization is key in this process. You likely have limited resources, time, energy, money, and you can't pursue every possible strategy simultaneously. Evaluate each potential strategy based on its potential impact, the resources required, and its alignment with your overall objectives. Focus your efforts on the strategies that offer the highest return on investment. Once you've identified your key strategies, break them down into specific action steps. What exactly needs to be done to implement each strategy? Who needs to be involved? What resources are required? By defining these details, you create a clear roadmap for execution. However, no plan survives contact with reality unchanged. The game of life is dynamic, with unexpected challenges and opportunities arising constantly. That's why contingency planning is a crucial part of crafting your game plan. For each major strategy, consider potential obstacles or setbacks you might encounter. What could go wrong? How might other players react to your moves? Develop contingency plans for these scenarios, outlining how you'll respond if things don't go as expected. This preparation not only helps you navigate challenges more effectively, but also builds your confidence, knowing you have a backup plan. Flexibility is the hallmark of a strong game plan. While it's important to have a clear direction, it's equally important to remain adaptable. Build checkpoints into your plan where you'll reassess your strategies based on your progress and any changes in your playing field. Be prepared to pivot if necessary, adjusting your tactics or even your overall strategy if circumstances demand it. To aid in the development and refinement of your strategies, consider employing tools and frameworks from the business world. A SWOT analysis, for example, can help you evaluate your strengths, weaknesses, opportunities, and threats in relation to your goals. This structured approach can reveal insights that might not be apparent at first glance. Scenario planning is another powerful tool for strategic thinking. Imagine different possible futures, both positive and negative, and consider how your strategies would fare in each scenario. This exercise can help you develop more robust, flexible strategies that can succeed under various conditions. As you craft your game plan, remember that strategy is as much an art as it is a science. While analytical tools and frameworks are valuable, don't underestimate the power of intuition and creativity. Some of the most successful strategies in history have come from thinking outside the box, from seeing possibilities that others missed. Your game plan should be a living document, one that evolves as you progress and as circumstances change. Regularly review and refine your strategies, celebrating your successes and learning from your setbacks. Each move you make in the game of life provides valuable feedback that can inform and improve your overall strategy. As we conclude this exploration of strategy development, you should have the beginnings of a robust game plan. You've developed strategies aligned with your goals, broken them down into actionable steps, and prepared for potential obstacles. You've embraced the need for both structure and flexibility in your planning. But even the best-laid plans face moments of uncertainty and challenge. In our next chapter, we'll delve into the art of decision-making under uncertainty, exploring how to navigate the fog of war that often obscures our path in the game of life. Your strategies are set. Now it's time to prepare for the unpredictable twists and turns that lie ahead. Chapter 7, Decision-Making Under Uncertainty. In the intricate game of life, uncertainty is the only certainty. No matter how well we plan or how thoroughly we analyze, there will always be factors beyond our control, unknown variables that can dramatically impact our outcomes. The ability to make sound decisions in the face of this uncertainty is what separates master players from novices. Uncertainty comes in many forms. There's the known unknowns, factors we're aware of but can't predict, like market fluctuations or competitor actions. Then there's the unknown unknowns, the surprises that blindside us, the black swan events that reshape entire landscapes overnight. Understanding the nature of the uncertainty you face is the first step in navigating it effectively. The impact of uncertainty on decision-making cannot be overstated. It can paralyze us with indecision, push us towards overly cautious choices, or drive us to reckless gambles. But with the right tools and mindset, uncertainty can also be a source of opportunity, a chance to outmaneuver less prepared players and seize advantages others miss. One powerful tool for decision-making under uncertainty is the decision tree. This visual representation of possible choices and their potential outcomes allows us to map out complex scenarios and evaluate our options systematically. By assigning probabilities and values to different outcomes, we can calculate the expected value of each decision path, providing a quantitative basis for our choices. Probability and statistics are your allies in the face of uncertainty. While they can't predict the future with certainty, they can give us a more nuanced understanding of the likelihood of different outcomes. Techniques like Monte Carlo simulations can help us model complex scenarios with multiple variables, giving us a clearer picture of the range of possible outcomes and their probabilities. However, it's crucial to remember that these tools are aids to decision-making, not substitutes for judgment. The quality of the outputs depends on the quality of the inputs. And in many real-world scenarios, we're dealing with incomplete or imperfect information. This is where the art of decision-making comes into play, blending analytical insights with intuition and experience. One key principle in decision-making under uncertainty is to focus on what you can control. While we can't eliminate uncertainty, we can often reduce it through research, analysis, and careful planning. Identify the key variables that will impact your outcomes and focus your efforts on gathering information and developing contingency plans around these factors. Another crucial strategy is to maintain flexibility in your decisions. Instead of committing fully to a single course of action, look for options that allow you to adapt as new information becomes available. This might involve breaking big decisions into smaller steps, creating pilot projects to test assumptions, or building in exit strategies for major commitments. Risk management is an essential component of decision-making under uncertainty. This doesn't mean avoiding risk. In many cases, the biggest risk is taking no risk at all. Instead, it means understanding the potential downsides of your decisions and taking steps to mitigate them. Diversification, hedging strategies, and insurance are all tools that can help manage risk in various contexts. As you navigate uncertainty, it's important to cultivate a mindset of adaptability and resilience. Unexpected setbacks are inevitable, but they don't have to derail your entire strategy. View these challenges as opportunities for learning and adjustment, chances to refine your approach and come back stronger. Remember, decision-making under uncertainty is not about achieving perfect outcomes. It's about making the best choices possible with the information available. Embrace the idea of satisficing, making decisions that are good enough given the constraints and uncertainties you face, rather than endlessly searching for an elusive, perfect solution. As we conclude this exploration of decision-making under uncertainty, you should have a clearer understanding of how to navigate the fog of war that often obscures our path in the game of life. You've learned about tools for analyzing complex scenarios, strategies for managing risk, and mindsets for thriving amidst unpredictability. But decision-making doesn't happen in a vacuum. In our next chapter, we'll delve into the art of negotiation and conflict resolution, exploring how to navigate the complex interpersonal dynamics that often surround our most important decisions. The die may be cast, but the game is far from over. Chapter 8, The Art of Negotiation and Conflict Resolution. In the grand game of life, rare is the player who can achieve their goals in isolation. Our success often depends on our ability to work with others, to find common ground, and to resolve conflicts productively. This is where the art of negotiation becomes a crucial skill in your strategic toolkit. Negotiation is far more than just haggling over prices or terms. It's a nuanced dance of communication, persuasion, and mutual problem solving. At its core, effective negotiation is about creating value for all parties involved, not just claiming value for yourself. The foundation of successful negotiation lies in thorough preparation. Before entering any negotiation, take the time to clearly define your objectives. What's your ideal outcome? What's your walkaway point? What are you willing to concede? Understanding your own position is crucial, but equally important is trying to understand the other party's perspective. What are their likely goals and constraints? What might they value that you could offer? One key principle in negotiation is the concept of BATNA, best alternative to a negotiated agreement. Your BATNA is your fallback position, what you'll do if the negotiation fails. Understanding your BATNA gives you power in the negotiation, as it defines the point at which you're better off walking away. Equally important is trying to understand and influence the other party's BATNA. Effective negotiation tactics often revolve around creating and claiming value. Look for opportunities to expand the pie before dividing it. Are there additional resources or options that could be brought into the negotiation to create mutual benefits? Can you find creative solutions that address both parties' underlying interests rather than just their stated positions? When it comes to the actual negotiation process, clear and effective communication is paramount. Listen actively to understand the other party's perspective, not just to formulate your response. Ask probing questions to uncover underlying interests and concerns. Be clear and specific in your own communication, avoiding ambiguity that could lead to misunderstandings or conflict down the line. Emotions play a significant role in negotiations, and managing them, both your own and others, is a crucial skill. Stay calm and composed, even in the face of provocative behavior. Recognize and acknowledge emotions without being controlled by them. Remember, the goal is to be hard on the problem, not on the people. Conflict is an inevitable part of any negotiation process, and indeed, of life itself. The key is not to avoid conflict, but to manage it productively. View conflicts as opportunities for greater understanding and creative problem-solving, rather than as win-lose battles. When conflicts arise, start by identifying the source. Is it a conflict of interests, where parties are competing for limited resources? A conflict of values, where fundamental beliefs are at odds? Or perhaps a conflict of understanding, where miscommunication has led to disagreement? Understanding the nature of the conflict is the first step in resolving it. One powerful technique for conflict resolution is reframing. This involves shifting the perspective on the conflict, often by elevating the discussion to focus on higher-level shared goals or values. By reframing the conflict, you can often find common ground that was previously obscured. Another key strategy is to separate the people from the problem. In the heat of conflict, it's easy to view the other party as the enemy, but by focusing on attacking the issue rather than the individuals, you create space for collaborative problem-solving. When conflicts seem intractable, consider bringing in a neutral third party. Mediators can provide a fresh perspective, facilitate communication, and help parties find creative solutions they might not see on their own. Remember, the goal in most negotiations and conflicts should be to create win-win outcomes. While there may be situations where a win-lose result is unavoidable, in the long game of life, sustainable success often depends on building positive relationships and reputations. A win-at-all-costs mentality might yield short-term gains, but it can close doors and burn bridges in ways that limit your future options. As we conclude this exploration of negotiation and conflict resolution, you should have a clearer understanding of how to navigate the complex interpersonal dynamics that often surround our most important decisions and interactions. You've learned strategies for creating value in negotiations, techniques for managing conflicts productively, and approaches for building sustainable relationships. But even the most skilled negotiator must know their own strengths and weaknesses. In our next chapter, we'll delve into the crucial process of self-assessment and personal development, exploring how to leverage your unique strengths and address your weaknesses to play your best possible game. The negotiation table may be clear, but the most important dialogue is often the one you have with yourself. Chapter 9, Leveraging Strengths and Addressing Weaknesses. In the intricate game of life, self-awareness is your secret weapon. Understanding your own strengths and weaknesses is crucial to developing effective strategies, making wise decisions, and ultimately achieving your goals. It's about playing your own game, not someone else's. The journey of self-assessment begins with honest introspection. What are you naturally good at? What energizes you? Where do you consistently excel? These are likely your strengths. Conversely, what tasks do you struggle with? Where do you often fall short of your own expectations? These areas may represent your weaknesses. However, identifying your strengths and weaknesses isn't always straightforward. Our self-perception can be clouded by biases, past experiences, and societal expectations. This is where tools for self-analysis come into play. Personality assessments like the Myers-Briggs Type Indicator or the Big Five can provide insights into your natural tendencies and preferences. Skills assessments can help you objectively evaluate your capabilities in various areas. Feedback from others is another invaluable source of insight. Seek input from colleagues, mentors, friends, and family. Their perspectives can highlight blind spots in your self-assessment and provide a more rounded view of your strengths and weaknesses. Once you've identified your strengths, the key is to leverage them strategically. Your strengths are your competitive advantage in the game of life. They're the areas where you're most likely to excel and find fulfillment. Look for opportunities to apply your strengths in new and innovative ways. Can you reframe your current challenges to better align with your natural talents? Developing your strengths further is a powerful strategy for personal growth. The theory of deliberate practice suggests that focused, intentional effort in areas of natural aptitude can lead to exceptional performance. Invest time and resources in honing your strengths, pushing the boundaries of what you thought possible. However, don't fall into the trap of ignoring your weaknesses entirely. While it's generally more productive to play to your strengths, there may be critical weaknesses that need addressing. The key is to be strategic about which weaknesses to focus on. Ask yourself, which weaknesses are holding me back from achieving my goals? Which ones, if improved, would open up new opportunities? When addressing weaknesses, consider multiple approaches. Sometimes, direct improvement through learning and practice is the best path. In other cases, finding ways to work around the weakness or compensating with other strengths might be more effective. You might also consider partnering with others whose strengths complement your weaknesses. Remember, the goal isn't to become a jack of all trades, master of none. It's about becoming the best version of yourself, leveraging your unique combination of strengths while managing your weaknesses effectively. As you work on leveraging your strengths and addressing your weaknesses, be mindful of the concept of transferable skills. Often, strengths developed in one area of life can be applied successfully in others. A strength in analytical thinking developed in your professional life, for instance, might be leveraged to improve your personal financial planning. It's also crucial to recognize that strengths and weaknesses aren't fixed. They can evolve over time with effort and changing circumstances. Regular reassessment is key to ensuring your personal development efforts remain aligned with your current reality and future goals. One powerful approach to personal development is to reframe weaknesses as opportunities for growth. Instead of viewing them as fixed flaws, see them as areas with potential for improvement. This growth mindset can turn the process of addressing weaknesses from a chore into an exciting challenge. As you embark on this journey of leveraging strengths and addressing weaknesses, remember that it's a continuous process. Personal development is not a destination, but a lifelong journey. Embrace it with curiosity and enthusiasm, always looking for new ways to grow and improve. Ultimately, the most successful players in the game of life are those who understand themselves deeply and use that understanding to craft strategies that play to their unique strengths. They're not trying to be anyone else or play anyone else's game. They're focused on being the best version of themselves. As we conclude this exploration of leveraging strengths and addressing weaknesses, you should have a clearer understanding of how to assess your own capabilities and use that knowledge to your advantage. You've learned strategies for identifying your strengths and weaknesses, approaches for strategic self-improvement, and mindsets for turning challenges into opportunities for growth. But personal development doesn't happen in isolation. In our next chapter, we'll explore the art of building strategic relationships, examining how to create and nurture connections that can amplify your strengths, compensate for your weaknesses, and open up new possibilities in the game of life. The pieces are in place, and you know your capabilities. Now it's time to expand your influence on the board. Chapter 10, Building Strategic Relationships. In the intricate game of life, no player is an island. Your success often hinges not just on your own moves, but on the alliances you forge, the networks you build, and the relationships you nurture. Strategic relationship building is about more than just collecting business cards or accumulating social media connections. It's about creating a web of meaningful, mutually beneficial relationships that can propel you towards your goals. The power of networking lies in its ability to expand your reach, influence, and opportunities far beyond what you could achieve alone. Every new connection is a potential source of knowledge, resources, or opportunities. But effective networking isn't about quantity, it's about quality and strategy. Start by identifying the key stakeholders and influencers in your field. Who are the thought leaders, the decision makers, the connectors? These are the players whose moves can significantly impact the game. Develop a strategy for connecting with these individuals in authentic, value-adding ways. Building alliances and partnerships is a crucial aspect of strategic relationship building. Look for opportunities to collaborate with others whose goals align with yours. These could be formal business partnerships, informal mentoring relationships, or simply mutually supportive professional friendships. The key is to find ways to create value for both parties. As you build these relationships, focus on establishing mutual goals and interests. What can you offer that's of value to the other person? How can their success contribute to yours? By aligning your objectives, you create partnerships that are more likely to stand the test of time and weather challenges. Maintaining strong relationships requires ongoing effort and attention. Regular communication, thoughtful gestures, and a genuine interest in the other person's success are all crucial. Remember, the strongest relationships are built on trust and reciprocity. Be willing to give without expecting immediate returns, and always follow through on your commitments. Conflict is inevitable in any relationship, and how you handle it can make or break your network. Approach conflicts with a problem-solving mindset, seeking win-win solutions whenever possible. Sometimes, simply listening and showing empathy can go a long way in resolving tensions and strengthening bonds. As your network grows, look for ways to leverage network effects. Can you connect people within your network who might benefit from knowing each other? By becoming a connector, you add value to your relationships and position yourself as a central node in your network. Remember, networking isn't just about what others can do for you, It's about how you can contribute to a larger community or ecosystem. By consistently adding value and supporting others, you build a reputation that precedes you, opening doors and creating opportunities. Strategic relationship building is a long game. It requires patience, consistency, and a genuine interest in others. But the dividends it pays, in terms of opportunities, support, and personal growth, can be truly game-changing. As we conclude this exploration of strategic relationship building, you should have a clearer understanding of how to create and nurture connections that can amplify your influence and open up new possibilities. You've learned strategies for identifying key players, building mutually beneficial partnerships, and leveraging network effects. But in a rapidly changing world, relationships alone aren't enough. In our next chapter, we'll delve into the crucial role of innovation and creativity in strategy, exploring how to stay ahead of the curve and create your own opportunities in the ever-evolving game of life. Your network is in place. Now it's time to spark the ideas that will set you apart. Chapter 11, Innovation and Creativity in Strategy. In the dynamic game of life, the rules are constantly changing. New players are entering the field, and yesterday's winning strategies can quickly become obsolete. This is where innovation and creativity become not just advantageous, but essential to staying ahead. Innovation in strategy isn't about reinventing the wheel with every move. It's about finding novel approaches to existing challenges, identifying untapped opportunities, and sometimes creating entirely new games within the larger game of life. The first step in fostering innovation is cultivating a mindset of curiosity and openness. Challenge assumptions, question the status quo, and always be on the lookout for new ideas and perspectives. Innovation often happens at the intersection of different fields or ideas, so expose yourself to diverse experiences and knowledge. Creativity techniques can be powerful tools for generating innovative ideas. Brainstorming, mind mapping, and lateral thinking exercises can help you break out of conventional thought patterns and explore new possibilities. The key is to generate a large quantity of ideas without judgment, then later evaluate and refine the most promising ones. However, creativity alone isn't enough. For innovation to truly drive your strategy, it needs to be purposeful and aligned with your goals. Ask yourself, how can innovative approaches help me achieve my objectives more effectively? What emerging trends or technologies could I leverage to gain an advantage? Successful innovations often come from a deep understanding of unmet needs or pain points. In your personal and professional life, what problems do you consistently encounter? What frustrations do you observe in others? These pain points can be fertile ground for innovative solutions. Implementing creative solutions often requires overcoming resistance, both internal and external. Fear of failure, attachment to the status quo, and skepticism from others can all be barriers to innovation. Cultivate resilience and persistence, and be prepared to champion your ideas in the face of initial skepticism. Remember, not all innovations need to be groundbreaking inventions. Sometimes, the most effective innovations are small, incremental improvements that compound over time. Look for opportunities to optimize and refine your existing strategies and processes. In today's interconnected world, collaborative innovation can be particularly powerful. Engage with diverse groups, participate in think tanks or innovation labs, and be open to co-creating solutions with others. The collective intelligence of a group can often lead to breakthroughs that no individual could achieve alone. As you implement innovative strategies, be prepared to iterate and adapt. Few innovations are perfect from the start. Embrace a mindset of continuous improvement, gathering feedback, and refining your approach as you go. Importantly, innovation isn't just about creating new things. It's also about knowing when to let go of old ones. Be willing to abandon strategies or practices that are no longer serving you, even if they've been successful in the past. This can be challenging, but it's often necessary to make room for new, more effective approaches. Finally, remember that innovation isn't a one-time event, but an ongoing process. Make it a habit to regularly step back, reassess your strategies, and look for new opportunities to innovate. In the ever-evolving game of life, the most successful players are those who can not only adapt to change, but drive it. As we conclude this exploration of innovation and creativity and strategy, you should have a clearer understanding of how to generate and implement innovative ideas that can give you a competitive edge. You've learned techniques for fostering creativity, strategies for overcoming barriers to innovation, and approaches for making innovation an ongoing part of your strategic toolkit. But even the most innovative strategies require resources to implement. In our next chapter, we'll delve into the art of maximizing personal resources, exploring how to optimize your use of time, skills, and network to bring your innovative strategies to life. The ideas are sparking. Now it's time to fuel the fire of execution. Chapter 12, Maximizing Personal Resources. In the complex game of life, your personal resources, time, skills, energy, and network are the currency with which you play. How effectively you manage and leverage these resources can make the difference between merely participating in the game and truly excelling at it. Time is perhaps your most precious resource. Unlike money or skills, it's the one thing you can never get more of. Managing time as a strategic asset starts with a clear understanding of your priorities. What activities truly move you towards your goals? What tasks, while perhaps necessary, don't contribute significantly to your objectives? Techniques like time blocking, where you dedicate specific time slots to particular tasks or types of work, can help you maintain focus and make the most of your productive hours. The Eisenhower Matrix, which helps you categorize tasks based on their urgency and importance, can be a powerful tool for prioritization. Remember, effective time management isn't about cramming more activities into your day. It's about ensuring that you're spending your limited time on the things that matter most. Sometimes, this means saying no to opportunities that don't align with your core objectives, no matter how attractive they might seem in the moment. Your skills and knowledge are another crucial resource. In today's rapidly changing world, continuous learning isn't just an option, it's a necessity. Approach skill development strategically. What skills, if developed, would have the biggest impact on your ability to achieve your goals? Where are the gaps in your current skill set that are holding you back? Embrace a growth mindset, viewing challenges as opportunities to learn and grow rather than insurmountable obstacles. Look for ways to turn everyday experiences into learning opportunities. Reflect on your successes and failures, extracting lessons that can inform your future strategies. Don't limit yourself to formal education or training programs. Some of the most valuable learning can come from hands-on experience, mentorship relationships, or self-directed study. Be proactive in seeking out learning opportunities that align with your goals and learning style. Your network is another powerful resource that, when leveraged effectively, can significantly amplify your capabilities. We've discussed building strategic relationships, but maximizing this resource goes beyond just having a network. It's about activating it strategically. Consider mapping your network, identifying the unique resources, skills, or connections each person brings. When facing a challenge or pursuing an opportunity, think about who in your network might be able to provide valuable insights or assistance. Remember, leveraging your network isn't just about what others can do for you. Look for opportunities to add value to your connections as well. By being a consistent source of support and value to others, you strengthen your relationships and increase the likelihood that others will be there for you when you need them. Energy management is an often overlooked aspect of resource optimization. Your physical and mental energy significantly impact your ability to perform at your best. Develop habits that support your energy levels. Regular exercise, a healthy diet, adequate sleep, and stress management techniques can all contribute to sustained high performance. Learn to recognize your own energy patterns. When are you most alert and productive? Schedule your most important or challenging tasks during these peak periods. Similarly, identify activities that drain your energy and look for ways to minimize or delegate them. Finally, remember that maximizing your resources isn't about pushing yourself to the limit at all times. Sustainable success requires periods of rest and renewal. Build in time for relaxation, hobbies, and relationships. These aren't just nice-to-haves. They're essential for maintaining the energy and perspective you need to play the long game effectively. As we conclude this exploration of maximizing personal resources, you should have a clearer understanding of how to optimize your use of time, skills, energy, and network. You've learned strategies for effective time management, approaches to continuous learning, techniques for leveraging your network, and methods for managing your energy. But even with all these resources at your disposal, how do you know if you're winning the game? In our next chapter, we'll delve into the crucial process of measuring and optimizing performance, exploring how to track your progress, adjust your strategies, and ensure you're moving steadily towards your ultimate objectives. The resources are aligned. Now it's time to keep score and fine-tune your game. Chapter 13, Measuring and Optimizing Performance. In the intricate game of life, keeping score isn't just about tracking wins and losses. It's about understanding your progress, refining your strategies, and continuously improving your play. Measuring and optimizing your performance is the key to ensuring that your efforts are truly moving you towards your goals. Begin by defining your personal and professional key performance indicators, KPIs. These are the metrics that truly matter in your unique game. They should be directly tied to your goals and reflective of real progress, not just busy work. For a career goal, this might include metrics like projects completed, clients acquired, or revenue generated. For personal development, it could be books read, skills mastered, or healthy habits maintained. Setting benchmarks is crucial in this process. Where do you stand now? Where do you want to be in a month, a year, 5 years? These benchmarks provide context for your progress and help you gauge whether you're moving at the pace you desire. Implement systems for tracking your progress. This could be as simple as a journal or as complex as a personal dashboard with data visualization. The key is consistency, regular check-ins, and honest assessments of your performance. As you track your progress, look for patterns and insights. Are there certain strategies or behaviors that consistently lead to positive outcomes? Are there recurring obstacles that seem to hinder your progress? This analysis can inform refinements to your approach. Remember, the goal of measurement isn't to berate yourself for falling short, but to gather information that can drive improvement. Approach your performance data with curiosity rather than judgment. What can you learn? How can you adjust? Feedback from others can be an invaluable part of this process. Seek out mentors, peers, or coaches who can provide honest, constructive feedback on your performance. Their external perspective can often highlight blind spots or opportunities you might have missed. As you gather data and insights, be prepared to adjust your strategies. The most successful players in any game are those who can adapt based on feedback and changing circumstances. Don't be afraid to abandon approaches that aren't working, even if you've invested heavily in them. The sunk cost fallacy can be a major barrier to optimization. Celebrating achievements, no matter how small, is a crucial part of performance optimization. Recognizing your progress boosts motivation and reinforces positive behaviors. Take time to acknowledge and reward yourself for hitting milestones along your journey. Chapter 14, Ethical Considerations in Strategic Living. As we near the end of our exploration of strategic living, it's crucial to address the ethical dimensions of playing the game of life. Strategy without ethics is like a ship without a moral compass. It might move fast, but it's likely to end up somewhere you never intended to go. Maintaining integrity while pursuing success is not just a moral imperative, it's a strategic one. In the long game of life, your reputation and relationships are among your most valuable assets. Short-term gains achieved through unethical means often lead to long-term losses in trust and opportunities. Consider developing a personal ethical framework to guide your decisions. What are your non-negotiable values? Where do you draw the line between healthy competition and harmful behavior? Having clarity on these issues in advance can help you navigate complex ethical dilemmas when they arise. Building a reputation for trustworthiness is a powerful strategic move. It opens doors, strengthens relationships, and provides a buffer of goodwill when you face challenges or make mistakes. Consistently acting with integrity, even when it's difficult or costly in the short term, pays dividends over time. When facing ethical dilemmas, tools like the ethical decision-making framework can be helpful. This involves considering the consequences of your actions, the rights of all involved parties, the fairness of your choices, and the common good. Balancing these factors can lead to decisions that are both strategically sound and ethically robust. Remember, ethical behavior isn't just about avoiding wrongdoing, it's about actively doing good. Look for opportunities to create value not just for yourself, but for others and for society as a whole. This approach aligns with the concept of shared value, where business success and social progress are mutually reinforcing. In the business world, the concept of corporate social responsibility, CSR, has gained prominence. Even if you're not leading a corporation, you can apply these principles to your personal strategy. How can your pursuit of success also contribute to the well-being of your community or the solution of social problems? Ethical considerations should also extend to how you treat yourself. Sustainable success requires self-care and self-respect. Pushing yourself to burnout or compromising your well-being for achievement is neither ethical nor strategically sound in the long run. As we conclude this chapter, remember that ethics isn't a constraint on your strategy, it's a fundamental part of it. By aligning your actions with your values and considering the broader impact of your choices, you set yourself up for success that is not only impressive, but also deeply satisfying and sustainable. Chapter 15, Conclusion and Next Steps. As we reach the final chapter of our journey through the strategic game of life, it's time to bring together all we've explored and look towards the future. You've learned to see life as a complex, dynamic game. You've developed tools for strategic thinking, goal setting, and decision making. You've explored how to build relationships, innovate, and maximize your resources. You've considered how to measure your progress and navigate ethical dilemmas. But knowledge without action is like a game piece left in the box. The true value of what you've learned will only be realized when you put it into practice. So, let's focus on creating a personal action plan to implement these strategies in your life. Start by revisiting your goals. In light of what you've learned, are they still the right objectives? Are they ambitious enough? Too ambitious? Refine them using the SMART criteria we discussed earlier. Next, map out the key strategies you'll use to achieve these goals. What are the major moves you need to make? What resources will you need to marshal? Who are the key allies you need to engage? Break these strategies down into actionable steps. What can you do this week, this month, this quarter to move towards your objectives? Be specific and set deadlines for yourself. Implement a system for tracking your progress. This could be a journal, an app, or regular check-ins with a mentor or accountability partner. Whatever method you choose, make sure it's one you'll actually use consistently. Commit to ongoing learning and refinement of your strategy. Schedule regular reviews where you'll assess your progress, gather feedback, and adjust your approach as needed. Remember, the game of life is not a sprint, it's a marathon, or perhaps more accurately, an ongoing series of interconnected games. There will be wins and losses along the way. The key is to learn from both, staying nimble and adaptive in your approach. The ultimate win in the game of life isn't about accumulating the most wealth, achieving the highest status, or even reaching all your goals. The true victory lies in becoming the kind of player who can enjoy the game fully, win or lose. This means developing the wisdom to set meaningful goals, the skill to pursue them effectively, the resilience to bounce back from setbacks, the ethics to play with integrity, and the self-awareness to grow and evolve along the way. By mastering strategic living, you're not just learning to play the game better, you're learning to design your own games, to find opportunities where others see obstacles, to create value for yourself and others in everything you do. You're developing the ability to write your own rules, to see the bigger picture, and to find meaning and satisfaction, not just in the destination, but in the journey itself. This is the true power of strategic living. It transforms you from a passive participant in life to an active creator of your reality. You become not just a player, but a designer, an innovator, a leader in your own unique game. As you close this book and step back into your life, carry with you this empowering truth. With the strategic mindset and tools you've gained, you have everything you need to craft a life of purpose, achievement, and deep fulfillment. The game board is set, the pieces are in place, and the next move is yours. Play wisely, play boldly, and above all, enjoy the magnificent game that is your life. But remember, true mastery is an ongoing journey of growth and refinement. To further elevate your strategic prowess and apply these principles across every aspect of your life, there's an exciting next step. Imagine being able to consistently turn your visions into victories, to rise above any competition, and to achieve remarkable success in both your personal and professional endeavors. These skills and more await you in the essential audiobook, How to Win at Everything You Do. This powerful guide builds upon the foundation you've established, offering practical strategies to sharpen your decision-making, enhance your execution, and accelerate your path to success. It's your opportunity to take your strategic thinking to the next level and unlock your full potential. Tap the center of the video now to continue your transformation journey.